Dear students, welcome to the introductory part of the Unit 1, Risk and Insurance. Generally, people are not at all ready to face risk, and this makes them reluctant to take decisions in daily life. In this world of uncertainties, we daily come across different types of uncertainties such as fire, flood, death, accidents, theft, earthquake, storms, etc., and losses arising out of such acts are of great volume and create a great discouragement and disappointment in this society. Hence, every common man has a fear for such acts which may occur at any time. Benjamin Franklin observed that in this world nothing can be said to be certain except death and taxes. Still, there are remains some amount of uncertainty even about these two phenomena. No one is sure when he is to die and what will be the tax rates and rules in the coming period, because the tax rate is changing every year. As such, the whole world is surrounded by uncertainty and risk. In this model, we are going to discuss on meaning, definition of risk, characteristics of risk, causes of risk, comparison between risk and uncertainty, classification of risks, and method of treating risk in detail. Let's go into the session. What is risk? The term risk is a psychological and relative term. It means uncertainty of losses. In other words, one does not know and predict as to when and how much loss be caused by some adverse future event. The unpredictable events may be called uncertainties. Let me repeat, the unpredictable events may be called uncertainties versus risk. Risk is often understood in terms of chance or probability of loss. As the probability of an outcome increases, the uncertainty as to its occurrence decreases. The uncertainty of loss is the basic feature of risk. So, risk is an objectified uncertainty regarding the occurrence of an undesirable event. For example, accidents, illness, damage by fire, flood, or other natural disasters. Let us see the definition of risk. Frank Knight defined as, risk is a measurable uncertainty. Irwin Fisher defined as, risk is the combination of hazards measured by probability. Let us come into the characteristics of risk. On the basis of the definitions, a few characteristics of a risk may be outlined as perils or hazards. Perils may be uncertain event which may cause loss, such as fire, storm, theft, accidents, etc. Hazard is such a condition which includes or loss of an event, for example, driving a motor car without brakes, etc. Uncertainty of events. An event may be risky only when it is uncertain or the occurrence is out of man's control. Let us discuss what are all the reasons of risk. Various causes of risk are prevailing. Generally, risks are caused by certain factors and concentration of pressure of such forces cause risk. A few are outlined here. Natural forces such as flood, storms, earthquake, droughts, etc., which can be subdivided as geographical changes in earth, seasonal changes such as excessive heat in summer, snowfall, earthquakes, etc. Natural calamities such as storm, dusty winds, snowfall, earthquakes, etc. Unnatural forces may create human forces such as tendency of customers and employees, lockouts, strikes, and chorus by workers, antisocial elements. Economic forces, for example, trade cycles, changes in demand and supply, market forces such as monopoly and competition, combination, etc. Government policy, for example, fiscal, monetary and industrial or licensing policy and numerous other policies affecting common man and business adversely. Other forces, for example, adulteration in food and articles of consumption, lowering quality of products, inefficient management, obsolescence, money market and others. Now, we can compare risk and uncertainty. Let us take few bases for comparison such as meaning, measurement, outcome, control and minimization. We will go one by one. The basis of comparison, first we will take meaning. Risk means the probability of winning or losing something worthy is called risk. The uncertainty is, it implies a situation where the future events are not known. Next, measurement. Risk can be measured, but uncertainty cannot be measured. Then, outcome. Chances of outcomes are known for risk, but for uncertainty, the outcome is unknown. Then, control. Risk is controllable, but uncertainty is really uncontrollable. Minimization. Risk is minimized. Uncertainty is not at all minimized. Then we will move on to the next discussion of about classification of risk. We can classify the risk with various ways. One is speculative risk, the other is pure risk. A risk is said to be speculative when there is possibility of profit or loss. For example, market changes in price causing profits or losses are speculative risk. Generally, introducing a new product in the market is speculative. Such risks are taken over with an intent to earn profits, but there remains the possibility of losses also. Pure risk. A risk is said to be pure, which may cause loss only, and profits can never be expected out of such risk. For example, fire, accidents, theft, death are called pure risk. If such risks occur, they directly affect the financial position of the firm and there are no chances of gain in any case. Examples of pure risks are fire, storm, accidental death and injury, accidents, theft, etc. It is possible that a particular risk may be speculative as well as pure risk. For example, a risk of loss of property by fire is a pure risk for the property owner. Pure risk can be subdivided into three categories, namely personal risk, property risk, and liability risk, which are explained in detail. Personal risks. Simply, personal risks are those which relate to person. Human life is exposed to numerous risks such as illness, disease, unemployment, death, incapacity, old age, injury, etc. Such risks cause financial loss to the person concerned or his dependents. Such uncertain events in human life may occur any time unexpectedly and cause loss. Property risk is of happening of certain uncertain events which cause loss to the property, such as accidents, fire, crash, obsolescence, breakdown are called property risk. House property, factory, godown, products may be destroyed by fire, etc., and a ship may sink in the sea. Loss of property may be caused by fire, earthquake, war, flood, riots, theft or dacoity, etc. Then we will see the liability risk. Risk which create financial liability on any person on the occurrence of an uncertain event are called liability risk. Say for example, when a vehicle collides with a man and injures him in accident, the owner of the vehicle shall be liable to the compensate the injured person for the loss so caused. How to face all these risks, or how can we handle risk in a better way? Now we will see the methods of treating the risk or handling the risk. Risk is the occurrence of an uncertain event which causes loss. Various methods of techniques are available to tackle the problem of risk, and a few of those we will discuss here. Avoidance of risk. Avoidance is perhaps the most simple method of handling risk. Say for example, when a person buys a motorcycle, he assumes the risks of accident and liability to pay compensation to third party in the event of accident. But the best way to avoid such risk is to decide not to buy the motorcycle at all. A risk of damage by flooding may be avoided by moving to another site well before recording flood levels. Risk reduction or prevention. So, risk reduction or prevention include all those methods which are employed to reduce either the probability of loss creating events or to minimize such events. Generally, it is impossible to prevent a risk in total, but every possible effort is made to reduce their frequency and severity. For example, in order to avoid or prevent fire, the use of fireproof building materials, slogans prohibiting smoking or carrying open lights, or use of fireworks, installation of firefighting apparatus, etc. For preventing or reducing motor vehicle accidents, construction of pavements, displaying signs of traffic at proper places are helpful. We will see assumption of risk. One best way of handling risks is to retain risk with self. It is the easiest and cheapest way of dealing with relatively small losses whenever they occur by paying out of one's own resources or by creating some contingent reserves or funds to meet such losses. Then we will see into the transfer of risk. Risks may be transferred in two ways. That is, a firm may transfer the activity which is risky, like stock market, either by hedging and by subcontracting. By making contractual arrangements to transfer responsibility for any losses. The next treatment of risk is insurance. Risks which cannot be avoided, prevented, reduced to a large extent may be transferred from one party to the other party. Let me repeat again, the risks are transferred from one party to the other party. The basic objective of insurance is to transfer the risk of a person to the insurance company, which can easily spreaded over a large number of persons ensuring of similar risks. As such, for handling risks which involve large financial losses or which are dangerous and uncontrollable by any single person, insurance is a means of shifting such risk to the insurer in consideration of a nominal cost called premium. Modern insurance system is capable of taking over largest possible risk relating to persons, property and liability. Among the various methods of handling risk, insurance is most suitable method. So, we came to the end of this particular session. So far as we discussed about meaning of risk, characteristics of risk, causes of risk, comparison between risk and uncertainty, classification of risks, and we saw methods of treating of risk. Hope you all understood the concepts of risk very well. The next session we'll see what is insurance, features of insurance, functions of insurance, and so on. Have a good day.